You want to take the antiderivative of x to the fifth multiplied by square root of 1 minus x to the third dx. So there are no fractions here, so your hint here is the square root here, right? So what you want to do, you want to set as 1 minus x to the third as u squared, right? You want to change your variable this way because the square root gives you a hint that you have to square the next variable, right? So you're going to take the 1 minus x to the third, the inside input of the square root, and set it to u squared. Okay? So now, notice that you can solve for x to the third that way, right? And why do we need x to the third? Notice that we can also split the x to the fifth as x to the third times 1 minus x to the third square rooted times the x squared, right? Because x squared times x to the third is giving you x to the fifth precisely, right? And I'm going to show you why we do that. So notice that x to the third, if you solve for it, you're going to get 1 minus u squared. If you take the derivative on both sides, if you differentiate both sides, you will get 3x squared dx is equal to negative 2u du. Okay? So basically, now you can solve for this part. Notice that this part matches with this part. So if you divide both sides by 3, x squared dx is going to be negative 2/3 u du. Right, so let's keep going now and let's see what happens. So x to the third was 1 minus u squared, right? So 1 minus u squared. 1 minus x to the third was set to u squared. The square root of that is just u, right? And then what? And then x squared dx, this part was equal to negative 2/3 u du. Right, so how about we put the negative 2/3 outside for convenience? Right, so that's negative 2/3, right? Let's put that outside, and then u du, u du. So now what do we get? We get negative 2/3. This is u squared, right? So u squared minus u to the third du. Right, so this becomes what? This becomes, the power is 3, the bottom is 3, multiplied by 3 is 9, right? So negative 2, 9, u to the third. And then what's going to happen? There's a plus sign because 2 minuses, right? So plus 2 over the power becomes 4. 4 times 3 is 12. Wait, did I make a mistake? Yes, I did. This was u to the fourth. Okay, we have to correct that. Right. I missed one u. U to the fourth. Right, because u squared times u is u to the third times u is u to the fourth, right? So this becomes a 5. 5 times 3 is 15, right? So 2/15 u to the fifth plus a constant, right? So let's put everything back into in terms of the original variable, right? So we're going to have negative 2/9. So u to the third was what? Notice u squared was this part, right? U would be the square root of that. Right, so u to the third is going to be the square root of that, the cubed square root, basically the cubed square root. So the cubed square root means we will have 3/2 as the power. Right, so negative 2/9, 1 minus x to the third to the power of 3/2 plus 2/15 1 minus x to the third to the power of now this is going to be u to the fifth, right? So same thing, the top number here will change, right? So it's going to be 5/2, all right, plus a constant. So notice that you can if you want, for convenience, you can write the right first, 2/15, to start with the positive coefficient, just to make it look nicer. 5/2 minus 2/9, 1 minus x to the third, 3/2 plus a constant, right? So in any case, both of these would be right, but this just looks better because the positive coefficient looks better to start with, right, than the negative one. In any case, thanks for watching. Hope this was helpful. See you in the next video.